Children, how are you all? Now in this video I am going to explain you about the another kingdom, that is the kingdom Protista. Here we will discuss about the characteristic features of the organisms belonging to this kingdom, okay, and how they reproduce themselves, that also, and other basic activities also we will study. Examples of Protista are fungi, some fungi, then diatoms are there, amoeba, plasmodium and paramecium. Okay, these all are the examples of Protista. So children, here you see characteristic features. So Protista are simple, unicellular eukaryotic. In the previous video I had explained you that what are the prokaryotic and what are the eukaryotics. So eukaryotics are having the well-defined cell structure. So next is defined nucleus, and also membrane bound cell organelles are present. Whatever the cell organelles, mitochondria and Golgi bodies, these all are the membrane bound cell organelles, they are present. Obviously the eukaryotic, whatever the conditions are there, they will follow that. Okay, then for locomotion they are having the hair-like structures called the cilia, that is present in the paramecium, whip-like structure, that is the flagella is there in euglena, and pseudopodia in amoeba. Pseudopodia is the false food, okay, not the permanent food, okay. As the work is over, this food will disappear, okay. And in the another way, wherever the direction will be there, there they will move with the help of the false food, not the permanent food, okay. It's a temporary food. Then some protists are plant-like with cellulosic cell wall and with chloroplast. Okay, chloroplast is there, that is the algae. Okay, algae, basically they are considered as plant also, but some algae are considered as protists. And they are autotrophs. These all are the autotrophs. That means they are able to make their own food. Then some protists have animal-like cells without cell wall, so, and the chloroplast, so obviously they will be heterotroph. Okay, they belong to the protozoa. In Protista, that is the protozoans. So protozoans, amoeba, paramecium and euglena, and unicellular algae, they are all kept in this kingdom that is called Protista. Now children, this is the structure of amoeba. Okay, so it is having the different features. Contractile vacuole is there, cell membrane is there, cytoplasm, okay, liquid inside, pseudopods, these are the pseudopodia, okay, they are the false foods, so that's why amoeba can change their shape, okay, so it's not a permanent food, that's why they can change their shape. Then food vacuole digest food, okay, the food vacuoles are there, okay, they will help in the digestion of a food, and here the contractile vacuole is there, and this one is the nucleus, this is the nucleus of the amoeba. Now here you can see that figure 2.6, which is given in your book on page number 29, how the ingestion of prey and the formation of food vacuole is there in amoeba. Okay, that means how amoeba have the nutrition, okay, how they are able to digest the food. So here, as you see in the picture A, okay, the food particle is coming here nearby, and as they came to know that they are able to eat this, then pseudopodia will start forming, okay, they will form this kind of structure as pseudopodia, and then they will engulf it, okay. So food being digested inside the food vacuole, here the food vacuole will be there and the food particles will go inside, okay, and then the digested food being absorbed by the protoplasm. So this is the process in which the amoeba is able to take its nutrition. Children, here the contractile vacuole is there. What it does, it helps in the excretion of ammonia and the removal of excess water from the cytoplasm. So this, they will collect the water from the cytoplasm, and then this one will slowly and gradually move to the edge of the amoeba, and then they will expel it out. Okay. Similarly, how these amoeba respire or do the process of respiration, they only exchange the gases, okay, with their surface, body surface, okay. So carbon dioxide will be given out, and the oxygen will be diffused inside that water, inside the body of the amoeba. As the water is having the oxygen, so that they will take the diffused oxygen, okay, the dissolved oxygen, okay, and that enters in their body. So through the body surface they respire. Now children, how they reproduce, that is, that means how they can increase their number. It is just a very simple process that is called the binary fission. This is called the asexual reproduction. Okay, they are developing, they are getting divided through their body cells only. Okay, so here you can see this is the amoeba structure. Okay, so if binary fission, there is one step by step process. What is that? First, as they will become mature, the amoebic cell will get mature, then as they will get ready for the division, then first the size of the nucleus will increase. Okay, and as the nucleus size will increase, then it can be easily divided into two, and sufficient amount of nucleus will be there in the in both of them. Okay, the size of the nucleus. Okay, so first the nucleus will divide, then the cytoplasm will get divided from each end. Okay, they will move towards each end and then it will be divided into two. So they are known as daughter amoebae, okay, or the daughter cells. Okay, so here you can see there is the importance of daughters, not the sons. Okay, so that's why they are named as daughter amoeba. Okay, now jokes apart, another is the multiple fission. Okay, binary fission is just limited to dividing into two, but multiple fission in amoeba is present. That means all of a sudden the so many daughter amoebae will come out. Okay, how is it possible? When there will be unfavorable condition for amoeba to reproduce. So what happens, as they will get mature inside, first they form a cyst, three layered cyst wall, that is the covering, outer covering, and it is hard one, and inside there will be the amoeba and it will start dividing on its time. Okay, they will keep on dividing, but they will not come out from the cyst. Okay, so continuously so many daughter nuclei will first divide, and first it will be formed, and then slowly and gradually there will be so many amoeba. So they are known as amoebuli. Okay, so inside that reproduction process will keep on going, the multiplication, they will keep on dividing themselves and dividing themselves, and it will keep on going. And as they will get the favorable condition, this cyst wall get ruptured. Okay, this will get ruptured and so many daughter amoebae will come out. So that's why it is known as the multiple fission in amoeba. Same thing happens with the bacteria also. You will study in 8th standard. Okay, so bacteria also divide with the process of binary fission and the multiple fission. So students, hope you all have understood the topics. If you have any doubt or question, you can ask in the comment section below. And the remaining topics will be covered in the next videos. Please like, share it with your classmates, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you and take care.